What's up, gamers? Believe it or not, but BIS has actually released their cards. What originally started as an April Fool's joke this year has now been released as an official DLC of the ARMA 3 game. The new card that is included in the game version update 120 and has been released just yesterday. It came as a surprise to me too. I thought it was pretty entertaining as an April Fool's joke, especially with the splits video that came with it. And now that it's released, I'm not sure how my feelings are about it. I guess a lot of people will say, why wasting your time on this when you could fix other issues that are more important to the actual core game? But if you want to be mad at BIS for that, you should be mad that they spent the time in the first place to create the April Fool's joke and not the actual release. Because already to create that video, they had to basically create the models and whatnot. And the next step to make it release ready for the public wasn't that big, I guess. Either way, it's here now, so we might as well enjoy it. Included in this DLC are a few infantry units, the go-kart models, as well as a bunch of empty objects and structures in the editor, which you can use to build your own racetracks. All the units can be found in the civilian side in the editor. The first character you saw there with the gun is called Marshall. This is basically the guy who starts a race, and the gun you saw is not an actual gun, but it's a flare gun, and he has also red and green flares in his inventory. In addition to that, you have four driver units, as well as four karts with matching colors and basically sponsored decals. There is also one random go-kart. This will basically, as any other civilian vehicle, spawn with a random color at mission start and does not have an actual sponsor design. The go-kart models are all the exact same thing, the only difference is the colors and the decals. So this is the actual content. Now, what else is included in the DLC? There are 5 single-player time challenges. It's kind of similar to the firing drill challenges, but yeah, obviously with the karts. They are spread out on 5 different courses around Altis, and obviously your goal is to complete the course as fast as possible. Also included are 2 multiplayer races, one on Altis, one on Stratis, where you can challenge up to 7 people in addition to yourself in an 8-player multiplayer kart race. And as previously mentioned, there's a lot of new empty objects and structures available in the editor now, which you can use to build your own racetracks and challenge your friends in multiplayer sessions. But you can have a look at me trying to handle those go-karts on the racetracks. I'm gonna take a few minutes to talk about BIS's DLC release plans, as well as their whole strategy behind that. Parallel to the stable branch update of yesterday, BIS, and especially the ARMA 3 developers, shared some written information on their website about the future releases, as well as how they intend to pull this off. I gotta be honest, it sounds like a very healthy and generous approach towards the community. BIS has always been known to listen to the community and to do the best possible for the community. I'm not saying it always works out 100%, but BIS definitely does a lot more than other developers do. I'm gonna leave a link to BIS's official web post concerning DLC in the description below. I highly recommend everyone to read this because, yeah, as an ARMA player, you're gonna be confronted with DLC, and this text contains a lot of important information. So the main concern BIS is confronted with is splitting up the player base. This is what usually happens when you release downloadable content, which you have to pay for. You will split up the players in the ones who have the DLCs and the ones who don't, because they're obviously no longer going to be able to play together, since they don't own the same content anymore. Already in ARMA 2, BIS came up with a pretty unique approach to resolve that problem, which were the light versions of the DLCs included in the official game updates. So basically everyone would own the entire content, but the people who did not pay for the actual DLC only had access to the light version of those, meaning lower resolution textures and sometimes limited functionality. So even if you did not have the money to pay for the DLC, or if you didn't want to spend the money on it, you could still play with other people who actually had it, but for you, vehicles, weapons and units would just look crappy with lower textures. In ARMA 3 now, BIS is not going to do the same thing, but they still want the entire community to be able to play with each other. What they do instead is basically release the full content for everyone, so no lower textures anymore, but sometimes limited functionality and some sort of weird pop-up system that basically starts to annoy you when you use one of those DLC vehicles for too long. A major advantage of this is that you can actually like pre-test the content before you actually buy the full versions of it, so you can see if you like it or not. And also when you play a mission which uses those vehicles, even if you don't use them personally in the game, you won't be bothered and annoyed with low resolution textures on them. So personally, I think this is a great approach to the whole situation. Most companies won't do that, they just sell their DLCs and basically encourage or even enforce you to buy the DLC as well if you want to keep playing with your friends who actually own this stuff. So what I want to say is kudos to BIS, they once more proven that they are looking out for the community. I know not everything is great with ARMA, you know me, I'm also complaining here and there about certain features and certain things that have not been fixed ever since a long time. But to this one particularly, thanks a lot, BIS, great job, and I'm looking forward to your future DLC. I want to invite everyone who watched this video to leave their opinion in the comments below. And again, please read the official BIS website post, I'm gonna link the description for you. A lot of very important information concerning this topic, as well as a look in the future to the upcoming DLCs. As always, thanks a lot for watching the video. Please check me on Facebook, Twitter, Steam, Twitch, Google+, and whatever the hell you want. And I catch you soon. My name is TheSwissMAVERICK. Bye bye.